On a warm Sunday morning, we set off towards the abrupt Hualapai Mountains. I almost wanted to call them the Grand Tetons of Arizona. I'd been this way once before, and we're in for a bumpy ride. I also don't like the look of those clouds up there. Could mean trouble. Hi, I'm Slim. That other guy is Glenn, and today we're driving over those dang mountains, straight up onto the other side. Just you wait and see.
Today's adventure begins in the foothills of the Hualapai Mountains. Alrighty, I'm in Slim, and this is the easy part. We're kind of in the foothills here. It's gonna get a little bit bumpy and fun very quickly as we head up the Hualapai Mountains. And as we make our way up there, I'm gonna explain what we're doing, but a little concerned about these clouds that are forming up here. And I don't know if it's from, I think there's a nearby fire somewhere in this area. So I'm not sure if it's that or if we got, you know, storms collecting here on top of the mountain. But we ain't stopping, man, we're doing it. This is my way home today anyway, so I kind of have to go up and over. So cross your fingers. Other than that, all around, it was looking pretty clear. It's just really quickly getting cloudy.
All right. How about I knock out some of the details of today's itinerary? You may remember the maiden voyage Glenn and I took up to the abandoned Boriana mines. Well, we're heading back up that same road, but today we're going to continue past up and over the mountains, eventually connecting up with Route 93, which is our way back out to Phoenix. There are a few things we might check out along the way, but the weather may change things.
And other than that, my expectations today, you know, doing some research and seeing other people's videos, is that we're just gonna drive through some really beautiful high elevation sky islands here in Arizona. We'll see the landscape change. I believe we're gonna see a lot of juniper type things up here, maybe pinyon pine, that kind of stuff. I see saguaro to my left, Joshua trees to my right. We're in that region where the where two deserts collide, the Sonoran Desert and the Mojave Desert. I think I'm realizing you can see my farmer's tan here on my arm. Hopefully we'll wear it like this today and get a little bit more sun. We are four wheels engaged. Here we go, folks. We're on the Boriana Mine Road. It's intimidating seeing these mountains though, right in front of my face here like that. Not quite Grand Teton style coming out of nowhere, but kind of like that, I guess. They just kind of rise out of this flat area that you drive up to, and when you come up on them, you just realize you got a lot of respect for those. And another thing I remember now is seeing a lot of doo-doo on the road here from cows, cattle. There's a lot that roam around this area. I'm sure we'll see plenty cows today. And in fact, I think I see there's like mines or something here. I saw something I didn't see last time, actually, but I want to go see. There's like mining, or there's almost like a, might even be a mine over here. Today's a lot about exploring, by the way, so it's not going to be like a tight episode. I think it's going to just be, let's see what happens. That was a close call. Look where I parked. I honestly didn't see it. I opened my door and stepped down and I saw that. I came really close to dropping my foot in that. Oh my God, that would suck. But anyway, I guess it's just cow poop, so mainly just grass. Although I'm sure that would have made a few of you guys chuckle if I did that and you saw it. I just noticed this area over here that's got, you know, looks kind of dug out a little bit, and I saw this wooden contraption. I see signs off the road saying stay out of mines, stay alive, and somehow I didn't see this little wooden structure last time, so we got to investigate this. It may be nothing, but if it is nothing, it's still beautiful back here in these mountains, isn't it? So it's kind of worth just kind of looking at this for our own enjoyment. This is what I saw from the road. And it does look like some kind of mining thing where they probably dumped some ore
there might be a mine on top of that or something like that. I don't know, but looks like some kind of feeder system where they dumped ore out here.
Now you guys can try to see me finish my coffee here. We got a little less than halfway to go as we off-road.
All right, we got to speed things up here. I'm going to let Glenn spill his coffee on himself and get caffeinated. We can sit here and watch him be a jackanapes. It'll be fun.
This is not good coffee drinking road. This road's a lot rougher than I remember. I just wonder if since last time I came here, they got some storms. A lot of rocks in the road. Way more than last time. All right, no sooner than I said I wasn't gonna film, this strange phenomenon happened. Like, these calves just kind of ran really fast into the middle of the road. I thought they were trying to run away from me, and then they just stopped. So, are they looking for their mama? You need to move, my friend. Huh. This is very odd. Usually these things are frightened and running away. Now that I know that cow don't have teeth on the top, let's go see if we can pet one. There's nobody coming, I think. I'm gonna start recording here to see if they get afraid when I get out. They probably will. They're gonna run away, I bet. Hey guys, you can't be in the road like that. Yeah, run away. Come here. Get on out of here. Get on out. Go, go, go. Go. Up, up, up. Stay out of the road, friends. Stay out of the road. I'm just looking out for you. I'm not trying to scare you. Ooh, it's getting windy. I thought I heard thunder too when I was getting out. But I don't know, this is a weird weather thing up here. I think we're heading like off in this direction, so maybe we'll go around it. But they're interested. They're not that afraid, but I've seen more fraidy cows than that.
All right. Not sure the best way to say it, so I'll just say it. I used some knockout gas on Glenn and took over the driving, and more importantly, I now control the music. I'm going to fast forward time and play a few riffs. I'm going to crank this up to close to 1,000%. We'll be at our first stop in no time.
We'll go check on how this ruin is looking since last time. And I never found the actual mine is another problem. There's more washout. There are so many washed out areas up here since I came last time. You see what I'm talking about here? We go really slow. Once we get beyond this point though, I think it'll be easy. Whew. Everything looks kind of like I remember it. Our fish friends are gonna be up that hill to the right. All right, let's get out on foot before it rains. Now, I think there is an old road that goes up there. You see all these like waste rock piles up there. I actually see cows up there, like something up there that's like too big to be like a bighorn sheep or something, and too white in color, like straddling the hilltop up there. So I don't know, the other road's gonna go up and over the mountain somewhere around here. We'll look at it. I know there's a road that goes up by the tailings, and I don't know. I got to study it to see if it's something I want to attempt. What I really want to show you, though, is the mine really quick. We'll take a look at it today, and the views, too. And here it is, the what I'm guessing is the processing facility or mill. Pretty much in the same state I remember it in, just completely demolished. And I'm assuming that's what this was some kind of system that fed in the ore, which I think was tungsten, is what they were mining here for, I think, was it World War I effort or World War II or both? But I don't remember. It's been a long time, but there's where we came from, actually. I came from California. I was in Needles, California last night, so
This is what we drove up just now. You can see the elevation gain.
It's gonna be a windy one, I fear. So bear with me if there's wind noise on the mic here. I'm gonna do the best I can. What might be more interesting if we're gonna spend time here is seeing if we can get up there. Because I've seen old pictures. I remember the pictures we have in our video that Amy found. Like there was this big like portal and it said Boriana Mine on it, and there were like ore cart tracks going on. It was pretty, like a really big mine. So I don't know if that's up there or not. There was like a miner shack or something. I was able to get the drone up there from when I was standing by the goldfish, which we're gonna go see next. And there's some cool stuff up there, I think. Maybe that's what we'll do then today. So if you want to see more of that and learn more about the mine, I'll plug the old video again. Like I said, the drone footage is pretty good, but wrong frame rate if you notice that. And some of you may not even notice it. But we're perfectionists here. And I see the wasps that I saw last time, like right here. But what we're going to do now is I'm going to drive down this like little section up there. And there's a spring where we have our goldfish. So I want to at least say hi to the goldfish. I'll see if we can survey a road up there. I actually see cows coming down the road. They're like white or really light brown in color up there. All right, let's take you over by these goldfish. This part's a little hairy too. Maybe by the time we look at the fish, the cows will come down that mining road and I can survey it and see if it's something we want to attempt or not. Or maybe walk up there, I don't know. That's another option, I suppose. Although this truck has made me much lazier of a person, and you know. Oh my God, look at this. This part here is a little nutso. Oh, come on, Slim. Am I gonna have to, there we go. We made it. Woo! That's fun. All right, I see water. That's a good sign. That means there's still a spring up here probably. Straight ahead of us, actually. There's actually more water collecting up here than last time, and a lot of bugs. Eee. I don't know how to get to my mining road from here. Alrighty, let's take a look and see if they're here. I don't like being up here during storms. That's not what I was planning on. But let's see, this is the little spring, so there they are, they're still here. As other viewers said, these things are very hardy, so they're gonna survive cold. I didn't count their numbers last time to know how the population is doing, but there's little schools of them all around here. See that? Are you guys curious what I got? I got nothing for you. That is cool. There's all the big ones in the front and maybe all the babies in the back. Yeah, it's the setting, I think, that makes this so cool. Otherwise, if we were just like at a, in the city somewhere at a restaurant and they had a little pound out front, I wouldn't even care. Ay, ay, ay. Stupid storms. It all seems to be like this direction, like south or southeast. And I want to say when we get up to the top, we have to kind of hang and go north a little bit and back down over the mountain. So I don't know which way that's blowing. I can't tell. Or if it's just collecting up over the mountain. That happens a lot in Arizona and these sky islands. And I'll also make note too that look at the vegetation. It's changed significantly since we started. We were seeing saguaro, cacti, Joshua trees, and way up here, none of that. Just juniper and some kind of pine, pinyon pine, I assume, or cedar or something like that. We've come up in elevation, and I'll look at the temperature in the car, but it's quite cooler up here, and I'm loving it. You guys don't care if it's gonna storm and rain. You're already wet. It don't matter, does it?
kind of weird how all the schools gathered when I arrived here. Is it like a protective thing? Do they sense my presence? And they're like, everybody collect in one giant school now. Some of the littler ones are coming my way. You guys think I have food? I'm gonna guess people throw food in there all the time for you guys. You guys are probably little garbage disposals, but I don't have no food for you. Sorry. Isn't that kind of wild? You have this high mountain up here, high elevation, and you got goldfish over here.
All right, so I've been finagling around and trying to get up on the road to get up and over the mountain. I think we're on it now. Boriana Mine's off to the left, really far below now. Maybe, actually, we're almost at the same level as those tailings over there. I doubt that this road goes next to the Boriana Mine up there, all the tailings, but you never know. And I don't know where the peak is up here, how far we are from the top of the mountain and going up and over. And I've not seen a single adventurer out here today. No motorcycles, no, or dirt bikes, I should say, no off-roaders of any sort.
I almost think we're getting up high enough where there might be pine trees. Ponderosa pine, maybe, maybe not. Just really big pinyon pine or junipers, I'm not sure. But yeah, the higher you go here into these sky islands, it just changes so much. It feels so good up here. It was 119 degrees yesterday in Needles, California. Off in the deserts that way that you can see, off by the Colorado River. And I could barely function. It was, I don't remember ever feeling that oppressed by the heat before in my life. So coming up here right now, where I'm gonna guess it's in the 70s now, that's my guess. And with the breeze, definitely. It's not cold or anything, but it's almost perfect, I would say.
You can actually see the Boriana Mine Road snake its way all the way down where we came from. I can actually follow it with my eyes all the way down to the flat plain down there. So it's really cool to see that. It gives you a perspective of you come up in this valley and then just come on up, probably several thousand feet in elevation, steep at times, and the mine is down there.
And a quick storm check really quick. I mean, seems to be holding steady. Curious to get up and over here, you know, because the darkness was like over here, and it still kind of is, but it seems to be moving north, whatever it is, or just shifting and changing. And like, we're, you know, these storms like to form on mountains in Arizona. You see it a lot in Flagstaff and other areas. So chances are, if you're viewing the mountain like from a distance, when I was driving here, it's sunny. You're probably baking in the sun down in the valley, looking up here at clouds gathering on the mountaintop. All right, let's keep going. Let's keep going. I'm enjoying it. Kind of like weird weather days too. Don't get me wrong if I'm worried or complaining about it. It's really just, I don't want to get stuck in a bad situation, really.
I don't know why I find that humorous, but it's like heading home from California and I decided to go this way.
I'm going to step in and speed things up, or else we'll be here all day. Allow me to summarize the next part of the drive. We drive a little ways up the mountain and Glenn decides to stop. Again. He looks down at the Boriana mines, sees nothing but tailings, and then we drive and he complains about the weather. A lot.
Come on, weather, just blow over. But I don't know if it's blowing over or just gathering. My point was, with the weather, I think it's just a good policy to don't get your hopes up. One thing I've learned this year, 2023, is the year of don't trust the weather reports. Very much learning that on many trips.
He constantly points out every rock we drive past and surmises about what if that one hit us, or what if that one hit us.
What if? Rocks and boulders have fallen here. A lot of falling rock and a lot of loose rock on that hill there. I just hope nothing decides to come tumbling down today. Like, look at that thing. That is big.
And then back to the weather. And back to how weather leads to falling rocks, and how falling rocks ruin good times, just like our host Captain Beyond over here.
What I don't want is rain and then rocks tumbling, because rain and rocks kind of go hand in hand in these parts. All right, had a little few raindrops on the window. Started to get in the car, the wind kicked up, and then I smelled rain. I see like some mist kind of down there too. I'm wondering if that's a little bit of rain down where I started. You could see rain collecting on the window a little bit. As long as it stays reasonable, we're all good. We're driving towards the edge of the world here. Look at that. Wowzers. Speaking of rocks, actually I think we might be able to get a good view of the stuff right below us from right over here if there's somewhere to pull over. This is not a spot very conducive to that if someone comes ripping around this corner on a dirt bike or something. But I probably can, oh yeah, this is a good spot because I can see traffic coming from each direction. So many fallen rocks up here, man.
And I was like, oh yeah, I'm at the top. I don't think we're close to the top in terms of the highest point by any means here. Look at how high up that is. That's gotta be another 1,000 feet or more, 2,000 feet higher, I would guess. I don't know, maybe 1,000. If I drew a straight line across to where like an equivalent point, I wouldn't be surprised. And you can actually see hiking trails that wind up the mountains to go up there. I bet you there's a trail that goes up to the top. And I think this is going to be one of our last views overlooking towards California this way, looking towards Yucca, Arizona, and Interstate 40 is out that way. If you want to head out to Barstow, that's kind of the facing west. Needles, California, the Colorado River, all that.
There's a Bob Dylan lyric that comes to mind to me right here, which is, you don't need a weatherman to know which way the wind blow. And look at this giant, I shouldn't say giant, but if that hit the top of my roof and fell on me, no thanks. Gotta be really careful right here so I don't drag and scrape my truck up. All must be recent, because almost kind of tempted on some of these to get out and move them for the next poor soul that drives through this way. Hope the footage comes out okay from the front of the camera here, because that's the excitement on today's adventure. More fallen rock everywhere around here, and it's always where there's either a drop off on the left side and that on the right, but just enough to squeeze by. I haven't had any issues yet. And I sure as heck hope I don't have any that makes me have to turn around to come across something too big that I can't move or have enough clearance to get over. Actually, I do see a big boulder up ahead that I don't know if it's on the road or not. I hope I just didn't jinx myself and predict that. Here's another one. Look at this. Okay, we got something pretty technical here to contend with.
I don't know if it's the way the GoPro rendered it, the viewing angle, or what. But trust me when I say, those rocks were way bigger than they looked. I'd be a liar if I said I didn't wince a couple times.
This is where I could really use someone to help me spot here. Come on, baby, let's do it. I think I see that rock right here. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Huh. Nope, that ain't gonna work. Okay, I'm almost there, I think. Come on, baby, come on, get up and over. Oh, Jesus, we're gonna tip over. Me. Come on. What is going on? I'm stuck.
There are times when you just want to say something to encourage cool, calm, and collected, but then you think better of it. And while I think it will all work out okay, I gotta say, not how I would have done it.
It's just now the worry is these big boulders that are just all over this road here. I tried to move one back there. I got out of the car. I wanted to inspect my car because I had to avoid one boulder because I don't think I had enough clearance to climb over it. So I went over to the right and then I got caught. There was a boulder off to the side of the road that I went up and over. So when you saw the truck start to tip almost onto the side, I thought I was falling over there. And my tire got up and over that, and then I got stuck, put it in a four low. Look at this. But if I'm being completely honest with you, if I knew in advance that the road conditions, even that if that one spot existed and I knew what it was gonna take to get over it, I may not have come out, I probably would not have come out here today. I would have avoided that. Just that one little spot. And if I stayed around longer to think about it a little bit longer, then I would have been done too. But my worry was, okay, now I gotta back up and there was nowhere to turn around. So the prospect was going backwards down the road for a bit until I could turn around. And I really didn't wanna mess with that. And there's a sign up here actually for something. And maybe like a place to pull off, find me. Holy moly, I need a break and we gotta catch up here because that was not good. That was not.
Waba Yuma Peak Wilderness. It is windy and rainy up here. Like just a sprinkly rain, like a mist. So, but we are at a peak here. It looks like there's even like a book to sign. I'm not really big on signing these, so especially not when the weather sucks like this. So I don't know if there's a trail that takes you up to the peak. It's actually chilly up here now with the rain. I'm getting cold. I need a hoodie. So you can see too, looking back that direction, I just see sun in the valley below just like before, but we don't get that view anymore. It's very pretty up here. We were very close to the top of something. But the weather is really not good right now. And I still have hope that we're gonna come up and out of this. I can tell you, this is where I start to feel nature's got it out for me on some days because it, based on the windshield, it was not raining. As soon as I got out, I mean, the second I got out, the rain's back. Like no, I mean, exactly timed. Explain that. But still nobody, still have not seen a single off-roader today. But I feel like we're now finally making good progress and seeing this side, knowing there's a valley, knowing that Route 93 between Phoenix and Vegas is somewhere out there where we're heading, I kind of have hope that we're maybe halfway or more through our mountain adventure here. Because I can't really say right now that it's pure fun. You know, it's a little nerve-wracking still. And the rain's pissing me off. It's thunder too, right here. All right, here, I gotta get, now the rain's forcing me back in now, God darn it.
Okay, let's enjoy the drive as we ascend higher into these mountains. Time to drop a few facts on ya. The word Hualapai translates to people of the tall pines. There have been people making an existence out here for millennia. The Hualapai Mountains rise above the surrounding Mojave Desert, with the highest peak being 8,417 feet high. As you can see, we've been on an upward trend since we set out, and these mountains are no joke. The Hualapai Mountains are a good example of a sky island habitat. At higher elevations, you will find unique flora and fauna, cut off by endless seas of surrounding desert. Sky islands such as this one are also host to a wide range of microclimates. Perhaps the weather that Glenn complains about ad nauseam is simply an example of a microclimate at work.
Oof, I just need a breather for a second, I think. I know there's raindrops on the lens. I'm doing my best. I can see my shadow right now, the sun. I swear, you see that? I'm not making it up. It's for real. The sun exists up here. Dang, is it beautiful up here. I keep going back and forth, having wild mood swings.
Isn't that a daisy? It's just untamed wilderness back here. Who knows what there is to explore and find in these hills and mountains. This is a narrow-ass road. It places up here with drop-offs that I don't even want to think about right now. Off to the side. I was not expecting this much excitement today, to be honest. I thought this was going to be rather casual and bumpy. For sure bumpy, but I was not expecting to be on the edge of my seat at times like I have today. Maybe that makes my job easier because I don't really have to get out so much because you can clearly see out the front what I see, the edge of the earth. All right, are we on our, look at that view. You guys have a beautiful view from the cockpit right now, I think. Oh my God. The tires slipped a little bit right there on some loose dirt. Off towards the side, I'm like,
It seems that we finally went up and over the highest point on our excursion, and the road has begun a downward trend. On this side of the mountains, the road is a lot smoother, and we encountered less hazards. This part of the drive had particularly stunning views. I understand why Glenn gets a thrill out of driving these dusty roads. There's nothing between us and the sky. At this point, our goal of getting all the way across the Hualapai Mountains was getting nearer, and the landscape we've only ever pondered from our passing vehicles has now been demystified. A sense of accomplishment is mounting. Well, what else can I tell you? The rest of the drive was pleasant. We passed through thick pine forests. The east side of the mountain certainly had more trees, and we noticed a couple campgrounds as we cruised through the area. We had to resist temptation to explore some of the mining history of the area and stay focused on the mission. While our tail ends at Route 93, Glenn and I still had 3 hours to drive home from there. But make no mistake, we've noted many reasons to return. Before I hand you back over to our host, I just wanted to leave with one final thought. We drove over those dang mountains, just like I said we would.
All right, this is where we part ways. I gotta get home. It's almost 2 o'clock and I probably have 3 hours of driving to do or something. So Sunday, gotta work tomorrow. If anything, we got one achievement done today. We traversed all the way over the Hualapai Mountains. We straight up went straight through it. So that I'm proud of, but just, yeah, I wish we could have done more.